Sthapakaya cha dharmasya sarva dharma swarupine avatara varishthaya ramakrishnaya te namaha jananim sharadam devim ramakrishnam jagadgurum padapadme tayo shritva pranamami muhur muhur Yathagner dahika shakti Ramakrishne stitahiya Sarva vidya swarupamta Sharadam pranamamyaham Namashri yatirajaya Vivekananda suraye Satchit sukha swarupaya Swamine tapaharine Ajnanatimirandhasya Gnananjanashalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Mannata Shri Jagannato Madguru Shri Jagadguru Mamatma Sarvabhutatma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Kayena Vacha Manasendriyairva Buddhyatmanava Prakrute Svabhavat Karomi Yadyat Sakalam Parasmai Narayanayeti Samarpayami Tejosi Tejo Mai Dehi Viryamasi Viryam Mai Dehi Balamasi Balam Mai Dehi Ojosi ojo mai dehi, manyurasi manyam mai dehi, sahosi saho mai dehi, shuklam varadaram vishnum, shashivarnam chaturbhujam, prasanna vadanam dhyayet, sarva vigno pashantaye, sarva mangala mangalye, shive sarvartha sadhike, Sharanye Trayambake Gauri Narayani Namostute Narayani Namostute Narayani Namostute Let us recite the Gayatri Mantram three times. Om Bhurbhuvasuvaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo yonah prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasuvaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo yonah prachodayat Om Bhurbhuvasuvaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo yonah prachodayat om. We meditate on the spiritual effulgence of that adorable supreme divine reality, the source of the three phenomenal worlds. May that supreme divine being stimulate our intelligence so that we may realize the supreme truth. Vani gunanu kathane shravanau kathaya hastau cha karmasu manastavapada yornaha smrityam shirastava nivasa jagat praname drishtisatam darshanestu bhavattanuna. Whatever we do with our body, with our ears, with our eyes, with our hands, with our mouth, with our entire life, let it be an offering to the divine supreme being. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Before we start our chanting of the Gita Dhyana Shlokas, today, 28th October, is the birthday of Swami Vivekananda's disciple, Irish disciple by name Sister Nivedita, Sodari Nivedita, Bhagini Nivedita. So, we have to remember her. All of you should know about her. It's a small video, about 2-3 minutes. Please watch what she has done for our country. Though she came from England, London, dedicated her life for the welfare of our people. So it is good for 2 minutes. Let us think about Sister Nivedita, then come back to Bhagavad Gita. A small video I shall play. Please read the captions.
Thank you. is the story of Sister Nivedita.
Yes, that is the unique life which all of us should imbibe, all of you should imbibe. What we have done for our motherland except criticizing or just living for ourselves. How much she absorbed the spirit of Swamiji and the spirit of India. Walking from street to street in Kolkata. At that time, British Raj, she herself is an English lady, Irish lady. Unimaginable, unimaginable contribution. And in our own people who did not have faith about our own culture and country, she opened their mouth and put this medicine in their mouth. There is a small story, then I will shift to Bhagavad Gita. There were 30-40 girls in Sister Nivedita's school. And she asked those girls, young girls, some of them child widows. She asked them, my dear children, who is the Maharani of India? Who is the Maharani of Mother India, of Bharata Desha? Without any hesitation, all these girls, young girls, they shouted, it seems. It is Queen Victoria, it is Queen Victoria. She was so unhappy. She was shocked. She was upset. Said, what? Queen Victoria? How can Queen Victoria be your Maharani? She is ruling India. She is not your Maharani. She is sitting in London. Then who else is our Maharani, sister? Then Sister Nivedita, with tears in her eyes, replied, my dear daughters, it is Mother Sita. Mother Sita is your Maharani, not Queen Victoria. You see how she got that blessings and awareness, Mother Sita. Then she asked some stories, something about Ramayana and our itihasas, our Puranas. The girls were not able to understand, unable to answer. Then she realized it is the mistake of the parents. They themselves are not telling them to the children. And children are thinking Queen Victoria is their Maharani. And what did Sister Nivedita do? She did not sit quiet or scold them. She went back to her home and within 15 days, she wrote a book, a story book. You know what is that story book? The Cradle Tales of Hinduism. The story of Sita, Savitri, Damayanti, and so many other kings, and Hindu sages, the rishis. All of you should read that if you have not read. The Cradle Tales of Hinduism. See the title, Cradle Tales. When we put the baby in the cradle and make her sleep, make him sleep, the baby, don't put film songs or don't put some drama songs, but put the songs of our culture, the stories of Abhimanyu, the stories of the great kings and sages of India, the scientists of India. Put it into the ear of the child. Tell your child, Shuddhosi, Buddhosi, Muktosi, Samsara Maya Parivarjitosi. This is the song of immortality. Shuddhosi, Buddhosi, Muktosi, Samsara Maya Parivarjitosi. Who are you, my child? Who are you, my daughter? You are pure, Shuddha. You are Buddha, awakened. You are free, Mukta. You are Niranjanosi. You are without any guilt, any stain. Anjana, Niranjana. And you are free from this samsara. Samsara maya parivarjito, aparivarjitosi. You will cross over this maya. You will reach the Paramatma. So mother's responsibility of giving this nourishment You become engineer. You become one doctor. You don't want him or her to reach God. You want him only to be selfish. Be a doctor, be an engineer, but be a godly doctor. Be a godly engineer. Be a godly lawyer. Esha vasya midag sarvam yat kincha jagatyam jagat. Cover everything with Isha, with God. Yat kinchit, whatever is little. Don't leave any gap. So then, Sister Nivedita helped so many people you saw there. Subramanya Bharati. He was not allowing his wife to come out of the house because of the traditions. She scolded him left, right, center. She shook him off. She broke his negative mind. And she made him write in Tamil so many songs about India, about patriotism, very famous in Tamil Nadu, called Bharatiyar Padangal, Bharatiyar songs. Oh, so fiery. How did he get? Sister Nivedita's guidance. Painting, Indian painting, music, Indian music. It is not for fanaticism, it is not for show, it is the real feeling. So that is Sister Nivedita's birthday. More details you will get in the net or when you see any website, and you will get lot of knowledge about Sister Nivedita's life and contribution. And you can buy some books and get more knowledge and more grace from Sister Nivedita, Sodari Nivedita. Okay, so we shall continue with Dhyana Shlokas of the Bhagavad Gita, please. 5 times Omkaram quickly. Sit straight. Om.
Pratibodhita Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Grathita Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaita Mritavarshini Bhagavati Ashtadashadhyayini Ambatva Manusandathami Bhagavad Gita Bhavadveshini Namostute Vyasa Vishala Buddhe Fullara Vindayata Patra Netra Enatvaya Bharata Taila Purnaha Prajvalito Jnanamaya Pradipaha Prapanna Parijataya Totra Vetraika Panaye Grana Mudraya Krishnaya Gita Mruta Duhe Namaha Sarvo Panishado Gavo Dogta Gopala Nandana Partho Vatsa Sudhir Bhokta Dugtham Gita Mrutam Mahat Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanura Vardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Bhishma Drona Tata Jayatrata Jala Gandhara Nilotpala Shalyagrahavati Krupena Vahani Karnena Velakula Ashwatthama Vikarna Ghora Makara Duryodhanavartini Sotirna Khalu Pandavairana Nadi Kaivartaka Keshavaha Parasharya Vachasarojamamalam Gitartha Gandotkatam Nana Khyanaka Kesaram Harikata Sambodhanabodhitam Loke Sajjana Shatpadairahara Pepeyamanam Muda Bhuyad Bharata Pankajam Kalimalaha Pradvamsina Shreyase Mokam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langhayate Girim Yatkripatamaham Bande Paramananda Madhavam Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Marutaha Stunvanti Divyai Stavaihi Vedai Sangha Padakramo Panishadai Gayantiyam Samagaha Dhyana Vastita Tadgatena Manasa Pashyantiyam Yogino Yasyantam Navidusura Suragana Devaya Tasmai Namaha Devaya Tasmai Namaha Devaya Tasmai Namaha Salutations to that God Om Brahma, Varuna, Indra, Rudra, and the Maruts praise with divine hymns. Om the Sama chanters sing by Vedas and their Angas in the Pada and Krama methods and by the Upanishads. Om the Yogis see with their minds absorbed in him through meditation, whose end the hosts of Devas and Asuras know not. Let us meditate of the Omkaram for a minute, then proceed forward. Back erect, head up, take deep breaths, slowly inhale and exhale. Shanti Shanti Hari Om. Let us go forward and open 15th chapter, please. We'll take up shlokas 10 to 15 for Parayana. 10th shloka to 15th shloka. Om Atha Panchadashodhyayah. Repeat. Purushottama Yogah. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Utkramantam Stitam Vapi.
bhunjanam vagrunanvitam gunanvitam bhunjanam vagunanvitam vimudhananu pashyanti pashyanti gnana chakshushah yatanto yoginas chainam pashyantyatmanyavastitam yatanto pyakritatmano nainam pashyantya chetasah yadaditya gatam tejo jagat bhasayate khilam yachandramasi yachagnau tattejo vidhimamakam gama vishyacha bhutani dharayamyahamojasa ushnami chaushadhi sarvah somo bhutva rasatmakah aham vaishvanaro bhutva praninam dehamashritah pranapana samayuktah pachamyannam chaturvidham sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto matta smritir gnanam apohanancha vedaischa sarvairahameva vedyo vedanta kridveda videva chaham Harihi Om. Harihi Om. Harihi Om. Very important, very beautiful shlokas and a very meaningful also. It gives a lot of clarity about how to attain moksha, how to attain Purushottama, how to attain the Parameshwara, how to become one with Him. And what should be done, what should not be done to avoid the samsara. So, in North India and in many mats, whenever there is a feast, bandara, they call it bandara, they invite the guests, they invite the other monks, other pitadipatis, and everywhere it is done, even now. Especially in the Himalayas, in Haridwar and Uttarakashi, Rishikesh, in all places, even when there are devotees sitting, and you can cultivate this habit if possible. When the food is being served after the puja or any occasion, they chant the 15th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, 1 to 20. And as it is being recited, the serving will go on. Number one, keeping the mind on God. Keeping the mind on the divine instead of gossiping, instead of talking something else. And the second is, this contains everything dealing with moksha, dealing with samsara, Yagam, at the mental level, at the spiritual level. Your goal, our goal, every Hindu's goal is moksha. Four purusharthas, remember? Some of you may know, one is dharma, the second is artha, the third is kama, leading to moksha. Actually, it is the other way. Artha, kama, dharma, moksha. But we have put, the sages have put dharma in the first because Whatever you earn, artha, money, wealth, business, should be based on dharma. That is the point. That is the link there. And why do you earn money? To fulfill your desires. And what are the desires? It should be based on dharma. It should not be based only on bodily comforts. Not just the lust, greed, jealousy, and disturbing others. Everybody has got desires. Whether it's an ant or an elephant, whether a baby or an officer, everybody will have korikala. Without korikala, you are Ramana Maharshi, you are a Paramahamsa. So, everybody will have korikala. So, fulfill those korikas as early as possible. And don't keep on increasing the korikas. The list should be somewhere enough is enough. And then have artha for it. You have to buy something, you have to eat something, you should have a good house. No problem. Absolutely no problem. Just because you are in the world, you are not a sinner. Just because I am a monk, I am not a paramahamsa. We are all in the flow. We are all in the train. That is the uniqueness of Sri Ramakrishna. He brought the householders and the monks together for the first time in Indian religious history. Earlier time, no connection with the grihasthas. So you go somewhere, you give us bhiksha, otherwise I will curse you. That was the status. And they were afraid and giving a lot of money and bhiksha. These sannyasis were enjoying huge properties. But then Swamiji said, what my master has come, not for one category alone. He has come for Vasudeva Kutumbakam, Vishwatma Bhavam, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. So from that time, things changed. Bhagavad Gita became a practical tool for you also, for householders also, for students, for wife, children, husband, mother, father. So it became open secret. Now you can learn anywhere. You can go anywhere. You can learn Upanishads from anybody. You can learn from Google Guru also. But that Guru will take you in the wrong direction. He will not give you moksha. He will give you only some information. Don't depend too much on Google Guru. Right. So this chanting is done. And once that Om Shanti Shanti Shri Krishna Arpanamastu is done, then you can eat. Then that is connected with Brahmarpanam Brahmavir Shlokam. And then food is consumed, water is taken, salt also is taken as prasadam. And when you take the prasadam, rice prasadam, dal prasadam, sabji prasadam, curry prasadam, whatever, sweet prasadam, puri prasadam, it is for purification of the mind. So in meditation, the most important factor is purity of the mind. Ahara shuddhau sattva shuddhihi, sattva shuddhau dhruva smritihi, smritir lambhe sarva granthinam vipramokshaha. If the food is pure, the mind will be pure, the thoughts will be pure, the body will be pure, your behavior will be pure. Everything will become sattva gunam. And when the sattva gunam is predominant, you will get memory of truth, or memory of truth will become strong. Dhruva smritihi. And what is this smriti? It is not telephone number or your address or your accounts. It is smriti of the truth that you are the atma. That will become very strong. However busy you are, wherever you go, you will never forget, because mind is always reflecting the truth. It is reminding you, you are the Atman, you are the Atman, you are the Atman. And that memory, smruter lambhe sarva granthinam vipramokshaha, that memory becomes strong and long and eternal. Then the vipra. Who is the vipra? He is the seeker of truth. Jignasu. Yesterday I told you. You are searching for truth. Brahma vichara. Vedanta vichara you are doing. So you are searching. You are knocking on the door. You are finding out the right method. Vedanta Vichara. Viveka Vichara. Such a person is a Vipra. There is no gender differentiation. It is all possible for everybody, women or men, gents or ladies, young or old. So the Atma is universal, only the gender plays the difference. Smruter Lambhe Sarva Granthinam Vipramokshaha. That Vipra will be free from Sarva Granthi. Slowly, slowly the knots will be opened up. Brahma Granthi, Vishnu Granthi, Rudra Granthi. Three knots are there in our personality. Lalita Sahasranama, we get this idea. Brahma Granthi Vibhedini, Rudra Granthi Vibhedini, Vishnu Granthi Vibhedini. His mother, Durga, Lalita, Meenakshi, Kamakshi. So, mother will come and remove the bondage of creation, bondage of Srishti, bondage of Pralaya also. So that the soul, which is caught up in this mess, caught up in this net, that will be free bird. It will go and become one with the Paramatma. Identification with the truth. So, samsara, samsara, samsara. We have to be free from the bondage. Now, in the 8th verse, yesterday completed, 7 also. 8th verse, he says, Shariram yadavapnoti yachapyutkramati shvaraha grihitvaitani sanyati vayurgandhani vashaya. When the Lord, here the Lord is not Ishvara, not Paramatma, but the Jivatma residing in this body. He is given a right royal place. He is given the name of a Lord of this mind-body complex. Chief Minister will be separate. But in the district, who will be there? The district magistrate, district collector will be there. He is the Lord. At that area, he takes care. He is respected. He is given right royal treatment. Okay, so here the Lord here, Shariram Yadavapnoti, Yachapyutkramati Ishvaraha. Ishvaraha is the Lord of this body. Grahitvaitani Sanyati Vayurgandhani Vashaya. The Jivatma is called the Lord because of his superiority over the body and the mind and the Indriyas. He has got 15 kingdoms, 5 Pancha Indriyas. Jnanendriyas, Pancha Pranas, Pancha Karmendriyas, plus the Manas, plus the Buddhi. So the Jivatma is the owner of, Lord of all these fellows. So he says, Vayurgandhani Vashayat. When this body becomes weak, when this body becomes diseased, when this body becomes incapable of doing any work, the jiva leaves this body, the Lord leaves this body, and with a big lorry, big van, huge containers. Understand how much you are doing, how much everybody is doing. Lorry is overflowing. And it is disturbing others also. So why are you carrying so much luggage? Why you are waiting for post-mortem heaven? And you are ordering lorry after lorry, lorry after lorry. And all that will go next janma, please. Carry over, carry over, carry over, carry over. Arey, bhai, kya kar rahe ho? Ayyo, tala kottukuntunnadu. Shankaracharya, you are carrying the lorry of the nose, lorry of the mouth, lorry of the ears, lorry of the eyes, lorry of the mind, lorry of the buddhi, lorry of your body, and thinking you are very, very happy. You don't know bad smell is coming from the lorry. Bad smell is coming from the lorry. You are going on doing all this drama. Right? So stop doing and take a new path. How and why? Next few shlokas will teach you. So the Jivatma assumes the upadhis, duties, attachment to the Prakriti, but through asanga. Asanga chastrena dridena chitva, we studied earlier. By detachment from Prakriti. You are wearing a shirt, it has lost its texture, it has become very dirty, and you throw it off. And then that means vasamsi jirnani yatha vihaya navani grihnati. It takes a new dress, it takes a new house, it takes a new residence. That's all. Death means that's all, which is a fact. Need not worry about death. Because this ruler of the body has gone forward. So little bit of philosophy, little bit of understanding of the scriptures is very, very important, so that we will not create problems or become a problem when somebody dies. You will tell others, here is the Lord who has gone to his kingdom. So he bundles up his belongings and goes to another place, intent on the same show. If he has done good work, he will get Uttama Punyam, Uttama Kutumbam, Uttama Mata, Uttama Pita, Uttama Bandhu. If he has done some mischief, troubled so many people, led an adharmic life, Adhama Adhama, he will come down as an animal. He will get not Uttama, he will get father, mother who are constantly beating him. Constantly torturing. He will be born in that samsara. So you decide. After Bhagavad Gita class, meditation class, where you want to be born. How quickly you want to get out of this? Uttama Kutumbam or Adhama Adhama Kutumbam. So this different departments of eyes, ears, nose, tongue, touch, like a bundle. He says very clearly, he bundles up, the jiva bundles up all the belongings. Big account books, and goes to another place, intent on the same show. What is that show? First jara, birth, then growth, then childhood, then youth. And while he is in the youth, dancing, jumping, drinking, dancing, troubling others, then infatuation. Then afterwards his marriage, or he gets a campus placement, then what? He earns money, then what? He gets some kutumbam, some children, then what? Children are growing, this fellow is becoming old, then what? Tatakim, tatakim. Then children's marriage, then what? No, 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 I'm not prepared to come now. I want my grandchildren to be born. Shuru ho gaya, big list. And children, grandchildren, they should grow up. By the time his teeth, his eyes, his ears, his sthula indriyas are failing. Hey Ram, hey Ram, hey Ram. He cannot get up. His son will put him in the old age home. Or in ICU, slowly, then what again? Same drama will start, he says. Similarly, the Jivatma spreads out his senses, mind, upadhis, assumptions, presumptions, impositions, always Maya Prapancha. He will withdraw from the body and he will project into another body. So then what happens to that senses? Next shloka. Shrotram chakshusparshanancha rasanam ghranamevacha adhishtaya manaschayam vishayanupasevate. So the jiva is the lord of the eyes, lord of the ears, lord of the nose, lord of his tongue. So today what happens in our attachment under this one, we forget the jivatma and worry about the indriyas, worry about external organs. We are worried about skin. Then for the skin, apply lotion. And some pay another thousands, another thousands, another thousands to beautify their skin. Facial surgery, plastic surgery. You did not know what you did last birth. Again, the doctor will remove this skin and put another skin. For what? Then you will go into the market like a fancy dress competition. There also bandha again. Then denture. They will unna pallu sariga undukondu daniki malla kotta design pedtadu. Daniki silver pallu antadu. Golden cap. Diamond cap. Another 50,000 rupees. Another 1 lakh, 2 lakhs. Dental surgery antadu. Oka roju anni pothayi. One day that golden teeth and his grandson will come and take the golden teeth out before his death. There is no end to it. And eye surgery entered. So he will do all that foolishness to be caught up in the samsara again and again. Nature is beating him. Nature is playing the flute and everybody is running like rats. Krishna is telling, Shrotram, Chakshu, Sparsha, Ityadi. The mind also, again he will start experiencing the same material joy. He will go to Haridwar. He does not want to take bath in the Ganga. He will take bucket of water and take bath in the 5-star hotel. This is the samsara. As soon as he gets down in the railway station, he will ask, where is the best coffee available? He is not worried to drink Ganga Jalam or do Ganga Stotram. And when Arati, Mother Arati Ganga will be going on in Haridwar or Kashi, he'll be taking selfie. Selfie leta. Yeda mokhaniki malla selfie no. Ade mokham, ade kallu, ade idi, daniki Haridwar ki velli selfie diyala. Couple of days back when we had the Navaratri festival, many people came to Ramakrishna Math Ime to have the darshan of Mother Durga. They were not having a Mother Darshan Durga. They were having their own darshan. Their own Durga, their own mukham. Makeup mukham, painting, zebra. And for that one lipstick, for that one vibhuti, for that one fancy dress. One jubba, kurta, pajama. I permitted or we permitted take photo of Mother Durga if you like. Beautiful image, divine image. But I was shocked to see where our culture has gone down. He is showing his back to Mother Durga and he is taking selfie comparing himself with Mother Durga. I wish he would have compared with Mahishasura. Mahishasura Mardhani is there. Instead of asking mother, let my ahankaram, let my lust, greed reduce, this fellow is putting his face or her face also. My God, these ladies also nowadays, they have become Durga's ambassadors. So then I had to scold. Is this Alarjan Museum? Is this Lumbini Park? Is this Indra Park you have come to? Do you have any sense? Again and again, last body, 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 body. 5 minutes, you cannot sit quiet and do Durga Sahasranamam, and you want your monkey face to be with Durga's face. So this is what Krishna is telling in the 9th shloka. Shrotram chakshus parshanancha rasanam granamevacha. Adhishtaya manaschayam vishayan upasevate. Upasevate. Again he enjoys the same thing which he did. This is the cycle of birth and death. Again he wants to eat chilies. Again he wants to go into the same gutter. So the sense of touch, which is the adjunct of air, pervades all over the body, intimating him of heat and cold in the environment. So the nose, so the ears, shrotram, everything. Because you have forgotten the electricity behind the tube light. You may purchase the most costliest gadget. You may purchase the most costliest air condition. But if your electricity department says full day load shedding, we will not supply the current today, sorry. What is the use of that costliest air condition? You have to do only arati and put some pulu. And you will take one fan and do like this. Is it not? Or you will go out of the house and sit under a tree. So the air condition is waste. That fan is a waste. That refrigerator is a waste. If there is no electric supply. We are worried about the attachments. We are not worried about the supply, power supply. So Krishna is reminding us, Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, think that you are going forward. But see that you go towards moksha, not towards that same quicksand lifestyle. Shloka number 11, please. Utkramantam stitam vapi bhunjanam vagunanvitam. Shloka number 10. Vimudhananu pashyanti pashyanti gnana chakshusha. Two kinds of people are there. Deluded people, undeluded people. Wise people, dull people. The worldly people and the spiritual sadhakas, seekers. What is there, this one you see, so wonderful? The deluded do not see him who departs. The deluded means mudhaha. Vimudhaha nanu pashyanti pashyanti gnana chakshusha. Vimudha. Mudha means ordinary. Vimudha means deluded. The deluded people do not see the electricity. They are worried only about the container. They are not worried about the content. Awareness is only at the body. Awareness is not in the Atma. That's where Swamiji Vivekananda took the Upanishad statement, Uttishtata Jagrata. Uttishtata Jagrata. Uttishtata Jagrata. Arise, awake. Arise, awake. Levandi, Melkonandi. Levandi, Melkonandi. Like a drill master. Like a parade trainer. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Why is he telling so many times? The students know what to do. But the coach is telling left, right. That means that rhythm, that speed, that concentration should be kept up in mind. So Krishna is like a coach. Gita-charya is a Gita-charya. He took up on the responsibility and took from the Upanishads. Sarvo Upanishado Gavo. All the Upanishads are the cows. Dogdha Gopalanandana. Gopalanandana or Krishna is the milkman. Krishna took milk from all the Upanishads and gave it to us as Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna was there to listen to have the love and affection of the calf, of the cow. Partho vatsaha sudhir bhokta dugdham gitam ritam mahat. Similarly, he is telling, my dear children, Shyam Babu, Vishwanath, Gautam, Lakshmi Amma, listen to me. Drink this nectar, he is telling. Drink this nectar. No, I want cappuccino coffee. I don't want nectar. Okay, drama start. I want only this and that. You don't want amrutam. Why? Amrutam will give you moksha. You don't want moksha. What to do? If you don't want moksha, there are enough things to destroy you. Vimodha nanu pashyanti. Pashyanti jnana chakshushaha. See the word there. Jnana chakshu. Very nice word. Very important word. You should pray. You should meditate on this jnana chakshu. Buddhi yoga, jnana chakshu, divya chakshu, etc. Okay? So, we have to be very, very clear about it. They who see possess the eye of wisdom. Those who do not see, they will stay and enjoy being beaten by the three gunas, being played by the three gunas. Gunanvitam, united with the gunas, sattva, rajas, and tamas. These three gunas make you enjoy, make you cry, make you laugh, make you worried, make you dance. All that will be going on and on and on. All right? Think about all this. What is going on, please? So, vimodha, their ignorance in regard to the self. Sri Ramakrishna says, in connection with this shloka, the human beings are all like pillows, dindlu, pillow. One pillow is red, one pillow is green, one pillow is white, one pillow is U-form, one pillow made in China, another pillow made in Hyderabad, Bashirbagh, one pillow made in Comerica, one pillow made in other places, in a forest. But the stuff inside all these pillows, what is the stuff? What is inside the pillow? It is the same cotton. Same cotton in all the pillows. Same U-form, only naam ke vaste, that's. Same sponge. Similarly, some men are fair in color while others are ugly. Some are good-tempered, others are bad-tempered. Still the same Ishvara resides in the hearts of all of them. Sri Ramakrishna. So whether it is Manoj, whether it is Divya, whether it is Anusha, whether it is Shalini, whether it is Bhargav, whether it is Shashank, whether it is Nityananda, each nose is different, each language is different. Each food habits will be different. In the same family, variety men, variety women. One will not like brinjal, one will not like cabbage. One will not like perugu, one will not like masala. What will the poor mother do? She will go to Zomato. She will go to Swiggy. She will go to Curry Point. Baba, I cannot manage this variety drama. Same family, ayyo. Same husband, but that fellow plays like a big dashavatara. What she can do? She is confused. That's why to avoid confusion, she will have a mobile and say, please get aloo curry today. And more enjoyment, more irritation, more karma, more kurma. And finally, death will be knocking. What have you done? Only karma, kurma, karma, kurma. Kya kare? When will you be free? Atma jnanam eppudandi? Vachedi, labhinchedi? Eppudu karma, kurma anukunte? So that is how we have to realize this, meditate on this and see what is the shortcut or how quickly, how soon as possible. ASAP. What is ASAP? As soon as possible. ASAP, moksha. As soon as possible, moksha. So that is what we have to strive for. That's why we are arranging these classes, so that some shock treatment, some awareness, some shake well before use. In the tonic bottle, it will be written there, shake well before use. Somebody purchased a tonic bottle prescribed by their doctor. He went home, kept the tonic bottle in the puja room. He went to the patient who was having 104 degree fever. He woke him up and shook him nicely. Patient Nibba. Wonderful. Patient Shekji suddenly pitched. 104 fever, he is already in coma. This fellow shook him, it became 108 degree fever. Then operation successful, patient dead. Idi mana nitya jivitam. One step forward, 5 steps backward. Then we say, God is bad. And some people say, what is the use of such a God who did not take care of the patient? This fellow kept the bottle in the puja room and was shaking the patient because it is written there, shake well before use. So this vimudha, this nonsense is what is creating all the samasya in the market, in the prapancha. So let us meditate and rise up from vimudha to mudha, mudha to gnana, gnana to vijnana. That will be a good ending for today's class. Please sit straight and adjust yourself. Chant the Om as loudly as possible, as boldly as possible, so that the vimodha, the delusion, that foolishness will disappear and we will gain some awareness. We will be able to get the reflection of the Atma in our own mind, in our own life. Be a little more confident, little more devoted, little more concentrated, and chant the Om without any hesitation. That is very, very important. That shows your faith. That shows your enthusiasm to become free. Power of the Om, the power of the Ishta Mantra. Okay? As you chant the Om, tell your mind, be free, be free, be free. Rise awake from this hypnotism. Rise awake from this delusion. arise awake more towards light, more towards supreme knowledge, more towards immortality, more towards the truth. Dive deep into yourself. Tell your mind, give instructions to the mind. Think that mind is only a indriya. Mind is only a subtle organ. Sukshma indriya, shashta indriya. It will be seeing through the eyes, through the ears, listening, through the mouth, talking, tasting, like that. Indriyas control the mind. The mind controls the indriyas. The buddhi controls the mind. And the atma should take care of the buddhi. All the useless thoughts, worthless thoughts, worldly thoughts, negative thoughts should be rejected, should be deleted, should be sent out. Vitarka badane pratipaksha bhavanam. Whenever there is a useless thought, foolish thought, pratipaksha, counter attack. Give an opposite thought. Anger will be there. Counter attack by love, by compassion, by seva, by patience. Impurity by purity. Fill the mind with high thoughts. Deliberately we have to do sometimes. Otherwise we are experiencing the same downfall, janma after janma. Let us develop the divya chakshu, gnana chakshu, pashyanti gnana chakshushaha, in the 10th shloka. Those who strive, those who meditate, those who continue their sadhana, wherever they are, under whatever circumstances, they will get the gnana chakshu. Others will be deluded, others will be unrefined, others will remain in the vimodha state only. They will not realize the gnana chakshu. Choice is very clear. Pravritti or nivritti. Nivritti is moksha, pravritti is bandha. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya. O Lord, lead me from the unreal to the real, false to truth. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. O Lord, lead me from darkness to light. O Lord, lead me from ignorance to knowledge. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. Mrityorma Amrutangamaya. O Lord, lead me from death to immortality, from fear to fearlessness, from falsehood to truth. Mrityorma Amrutangamaya. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Tat Sat. Sri Rama Krishna Arpanamastu. Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Pray for the well-being of all people. And what you give to the world, you will get back with lot of interest. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet. May all be free from dukkham, free from difficulties, free from diseases. May all be happy everywhere. May all be enlightened everywhere. May all be blessed with Gnana Chakshu and with Buddhi Yoga. Shri Rama Krishna Arpanamastu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Offering your pranams to Sri Ramakrishna, to the great, wonderful, powerful Gita-acharya called Sri Krishna, and also to your guru and all other teachers, all other saints, offer your salutations. Rub the palms of your hand nicely, please. Gently roll over your eyelids, forehead, face. So, namaste to everybody. Dhanyavadam. We completed the fourth day of the class. Still 2 days more. We shall complete the other shlokas tomorrow and day after. Be regular. Be attentive and reread again. Do the Parayanam again in the afternoon. And meditate for a few minutes as much as possible to the upper limit. If it is 20 minutes, make it 25 minutes. If you're already able to sit for 25 minutes, make it 30 minutes. So little limitation should be extended. That will give you more grace, more joy, and more depth in your sadhana. Okay? So this is the conclusion of this. What did you learn today? Shalini ji, what did you learn today for last 3-4 days?
Swamiji, yeah. Are you able to hear me, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay. So, yeah. Like in the past 4 sessions, like I learned a lot how to focus on meditation and doing meditation, what we are going to get. So, to be frank, like actually I'm from US. So, the whole day, whatever stress I get from morning to night, so it's just this 1 hour session is really helpful. And I'm able to focus a lot on my work as well through this meditation. So I got a habit of doing meditation in my morning time as well. So as soon as I wake up, like I just do for a small time, that's just 10 minutes. And in the weekends, I do some yoga exercises and all those things. But yeah, these are really helpful on making me to focus a lot on my work when compared to earlier actually.
Very nice, very nice. Continue reading, continue listening, continue thinking, and lead a focused life and see that this one is on the right track, on the straight track. Yeah. So whether slow or this one, keep it on the track and then see how the teachings of Vedanta will help you more and more, right?
Yeah.
So from this Sunday, we are starting classes for NRIs. So you send the poster to your friends and others there in different parts of America so that those who are interested or who can spend time. The classes will be for school children, 4th grade to 10th, in the evening, Indian time, 7 to 9. Somebody said make it 7:30 to 9 because zone in America, the different timings are there. We are ready to do it, but more students can join and boys or girls from any state can join and get benefited. Saturday, 7:39 evening, IST, and Sunday evening, 1.5 hours. We have moral classes, chantings, and Indian culture, values, all that we will teach them, we will share with the young children. Okay?
Sure, I will update.
That will be nice. Okay. Yes, Amma, somebody raised her hand. Who is that?
Sir, Vijay Lakshmi.
Yes, Sama, you want to say something?
Swamiji, Jnana Chikshu Shaha and Bhagavanduni Chudali and the temple, form of temple, Pratija, Manishyan. Continuous goundedness, Okasar Gutun, Mali Machpotanta. Continuous goundedness, my suggestion in this song. Okasar Gutun, maybe some Okasarito 1 week the Hawaii Gutun, Mali back, Mali tricer. Mali, continuous goundedum. Maybe 2-3 years out on the Malaga.
See, when you go out, will you forget your mobile? When you go out, will you forget your specs or your Aadhaar card or your boarding pass if you are going by flight? You don't. Because that is very important for you, kada. అది లేకుండా మీకు ఎంట్రీ ఉండదు, అది లేకుండా మీకు లైఫే ఉండదు అనిపిస్తున్నప్పుడు యూ విల్ డెఫినెట్లీ రిమెంబర్ ఇట్. ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ గోస్ హాఫ్ ద డిస్టెన్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు గో బ్యాక్ టు యువర్ హౌస్ అండ్ గెట్ దట్ బోర్డింగ్ పాస్ అండ్ ఆధార్ కార్డ్, లేకపోతే నో పర్మిషన్ ఇన్ ది ఎయిర్పోర్ట్. సిమిలర్లీ మొబైల్, ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఫర్గెట్, ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ మే నాట్ యూజ్, చేతిలో ఉంటే ఒక భూషణం, చేతిలో ఉంటే ఒక. సో యు ఆర్ రిమైండింగ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది మొబైల్ ఫోన్, ఇవన్నీ మనకు గుర్తొస్తూ ఉంటాయి. సో అదేవిధంగా శ్రీకృష్ణుడు అన్నట్లుగా అభ్యాస వైరాగ్య, కొన్ని వదిలేస్తే కొన్ని రీప్లేస్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి. ఏది ఇంపార్టెంటో అవి మనసులో ఉంటాయి. చెత్త, వివేకానంద అంటారు ఒక చోట, రిజెక్ట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ యాజ్ పాయిజన్ దట్ వీకెన్స్ యూ ఫిజికలీ, ఎమోషనలీ అండ్ స్పిరిచువలీ. శారీరకంగా, మానసికంగా, ఆధ్యాత్మికంగా మనకి మీ జీవితాన్ని బలహీనం చేసే విషయాల్ని వదిలిపెట్టు, దాన్ని కాళ్ళతో కూడా ముట్టవద్దు అంటారు. So it's a question of little more willpower, little more physically reminder yourself, physically. So adi manasulo oka pustaka pillalu cheptu untaru gurtu raatledante adi note chesi pettuko, lekapothe dan rendu moodu saarlu grinding cheyi prashantamaina deeniki. Andike prati roju kuda odalakunda ekkada unna kuda paarayanam chesi danni taatparyamu, dani oka inner meanings telusukodam prayatninchandi. పూర్వకాలం సంస్కృతం తెలిసి ఉండాలి, గురు ఉపదేశం అయి ఉండాలి, అవన్నీ మనకి ఉండేవి, రెస్ట్రిక్షన్స్ ఉండేవి, డిఫికల్టీస్ ఉండేవి. ఇప్పుడు అవన్నీ లేవు, థ్యాంక్స్ టు ద బుక్స్, థ్యాంక్స్ టు యూట్యూబ్ అండ్ అదర్ థింగ్స్. అయితే యూట్యూబ్ అవన్నీ ఓకే, కొంచెం వరకు మనకి హెల్ప్ చేస్తుంది, బట్ యూ షుడ్ అటెండ్ ది క్లాసెస్ రెగ్యులర్లీ, యూ షుడ్ రిమైండ్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్ ది పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్. దాని మీద అందుకే ధ్యానం అంట. అదే ధ్యానం అంటే దేర్ ఆర్ టూ థింగ్స్, వన్ ఈజ్ కాంటెంప్లేషన్, రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అంటారు. వినింది మళ్ళా రివైజ్ చేయడం, రివైజ్ చేయడం రిఫ్లెక్షన్ అంటారు. రిఫ్లెక్షన్ చేస్తూ చేస్తే ఏమవుతుంది, మనస్సు స్లోగా లోపల ములుగుతుంది, లోపల అది స్వీకరిస్తుంది, లోపల దాన్ని ఆస్వాదిస్తుంది, అబ్జార్బ్ అవుతుంది. సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఈ మెడిటేషన్ క్లాస్ అయిపోద్ది, సాటర్డే మార్నింగ్కి గుడ్ బై చెప్తాం, సాటర్డే ఈవినింగ్ క్లాస్ ఉంది, మళ్ళా సాటర్డే ఈవినింగ్ భగవద్గీత క్లాస్ ఉంది తెలుగులో, హైదరాబాద్ రామకృష్ణ మఠ, ఫిజికల్గా రావచ్చు, ఆన్లైన్ కూడా చూడొచ్చు ఇఫ్ యూర్ అవుట్ సైడ్ హైదరాబాద్. సండే మా ఈవినింగ్ సత్సంగం ఉంది 5:30 to 7, అక్కడ ధ్యానము, వాలంటీర్స్, డివోటీస్, వాళ్ళ లెసన్స్ అవన్నీ సండే ఈవినింగ్ ఉంది. సో మండే ఈవినింగ్ నుంచి మళ్ళీ వన్ వీక్ ఏముంది, మనకి కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ క్లాస్ ఉంది, సెల్ఫ్ కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ క్లాస్. సో ఆ విధంగా ఇక్కడ ఒక లింక్ డెవలప్ చేసి పెట్టిన, కంటిన్యూస్ ఎలక్ట్రిక్ సప్లై. నిన్న కూడా ఒక మాట అన్నా కదా కృష్ణుడు చెప్పింది, అధ్యాత్మ నిత్య, ఎటర్నల్ స్పిరిచువాలిటీ. రిలిజన్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఎ పార్ట్ టైం బిజినెస్. ఏదో ఒక వారం చర్చ్ లాగా ఓన్లీ సండే వెళ్తాను, 5 రోజులు తాని తంత్రాలు ఆడతానంటే
కాదు స్వామి. గణపతి సత్యనారాయణ స్వామి దగ్గర మెమరైజేషన్ క్లాస్ జాయిన్ అయ్యాం, ఆల్మోస్ట్ 1 year నుంచి ఆ మెమరైజ్ చేస్తూనే ఉన్నా భగవద్గీత. అదే ఆల్మోస్ట్ 1 year నుంచి అదే పనిలో ఉన్నా, అంటే అంతకుముందు కూడా గీత మకరందం అది చదువుతూ ఉన్నా, దాంతో గీత నేర్చుకోవాలి, చదవడం రావాలని.
సో ఏమవుతుంది, కొన్నిసార్లు సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ అని ఉంది మనకి, సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్. సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ కొన్నిసార్లు కోఆపరేట్ చేయదు, అక్కడ వచ్చిన చిక్కు మనకి. కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ అన్ని చేస్తుంది, కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ తినడం, పడుకోవడం, చదవడం, భగవద్గీత పారాయణం కాన్షియస్గా చేస్తూ ఉంటాం. సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ ని మనం ప్యూరిఫై చేయాలి, అక్కడ అబ్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ ఉంది. ఒక చిన్న ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇస్తా, మీ అర్లీ మార్నింగ్ మీరు లేచి, తొందరగా లేచి మీరు ట్యాప్, మీ వాటర్ వాష్ బేసిన్ ఓపెన్ చేస్తారు, ట్యాప్ ఓపెన్ చేస్తారు. ట్యాప్ ఓపెన్ చేస్తే షాక్ అండ్ సర్ప్రైజ్, చాలా తక్కువ నీళ్ళు వస్తున్నాయి, ప్రెషర్ రావట్లేదు, మీ ముక్కలించుకోవడానికి కూడా అంత నీళ్లు సరిపడలేదు, జస్ట్ డ్రాప్ బై డ్రాప్ పడుతుంది. మీకు ఆ సర్ప్రైజ్ అవుద్ది, మళ్ళీ లేచిపోయారు మీరు, ట్రైన్కి వెళ్ళాలి, ఇంటి పనులు చేసుకోవాలి, బ్రష్ చేసుకోవాలి అయినా అనుకుంటే ఏంటి నీళ్లే రావట్లేదు అని మీరు ఫస్ట్ డౌట్ మీ మనసులో ఏమొస్తుంది చెప్పండి. ఫస్ట్ డౌట్, సందేహం మనసులో ఏమొస్తుంది చెప్పండి, ట్యాంక్లో నీళ్లు లేవు. వెరీ నైస్. సో మీరే వెళ్తారు, మీరే లేచిపోయారు కాబట్టి తొందరగా యు గో అప్ టు ద టెరేస్, ఓపెన్ ది దిస్ వన్ డోర్ ఆఫ్ ది ట్యాంక్. ఇంకా షాక్ ఏమిటంటే ట్యాంక్ నిండా నీళ్లు ఉన్నాయి, full water, corporation water, or you somebody has switched on the motor, sump nunchi pai vidipoyi neellu undi. So first doubt ki meeku sandeham ledu, clarify vachesi. అయింది అంతే కదా, ఎక్కడో బ్లాక్ అయింది, ఎక్కడో లీక్ అవుతుంది, ఎక్కడో తెలియదు నాకు. సో ఏం చేస్తారు మీరు, ఆ పైప్ లైన్ అంతా చూసుకొని వస్తారు. గాట్ ది పాయింట్? అన్ని చూసుకొని వస్తే ఎక్కడో జంక్షన్ లో తుప్పు బట్టి, లేక అక్కడ ఎవరో బంద్ చేసి ఉంటారు, లేక తుప్పు బట్టి ఉంటుంది, అక్కడి నుంచి నీళ్లు రావటం లేదు, అక్కడి నుంచి నీళ్లు లీక్ అయిపోతుంది. ఇది వాటర్ వేస్టేజ్. ఏమి చేస్తారు అప్పుడు? కూర్చొని ఇడుస్తారా? కూర్చొని బాధపడతారా? అయ్యో నా కర్మ, అయ్యో నా కర్మ అని ఇంకా ఇంకా బాధ. వాట్ విల్ యూ డూ? ఫస్ట్ యూ విల్ డూ సమ్ ఫస్ట్ ఎయిడ్, ఏదో టెంపరీ రిపేర్ ఇట్, అండ్ దెన్ యూ విల్ గెట్ సమ్ వాటర్, ఫినిష్ యువర్ వర్క్, దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్వర్డ్స్ యూ గో టు ద ప్లంబర్ అండ్ కాల్ హిమ్ అండ్ రిపేర్ యువర్ పైప్, పుట్ ఎ న్యూ పైప్ ఆర్ ఎట్సెట్రా, మేక్ ఇట్ పర్మనెంట్ సొల్యూషన్. So just like you clear your water tank problem, similarly subconscious mind anedi avutundi. Ide mind management antaru. Ekkado chota block ayindi, ekkado chota lopaliki veltaledu aa pravaham anedi. So inkoncham teevranga, inkoncham omkaram, inkoncham durga mata prarthana, inkoncham jagajjanani sharada devi prarthana chesi, amma naaka divya buddhi ivu, aa chakshu ivu, aa problem ni nivarinchamma, na effort, నా ప్రయత్నం లిమిటెడ్ గా ఉంది అని కొంచెం శక్తి ప్రార్థన, మీరు శక్తి ఉపాసన చేసి ఆ దీన్ని బ్రేక్ చేయాలి. సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ లో ఉండే అబ్స్ట్రక్షన్ ని బ్రేక్ చేయాలి. సైకాలజీలో సిగ్మండ్ ఫ్రాయిడ్ అనే ఒక జర్మన్ ఉండేవాడు, సిగ్మండ్ ఫ్రాయిడ్. అతను మన ప్రపంచానికి మంచి బహుమానం ఇచ్చాడు, ద డిస్కవరీ ఆఫ్ ది సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్. పూర్వీకులు ఋషులు అప్పుడే చేసి పెట్టారు సబ్ కాన్షియస్ మైండ్ ఏమిటో. సిగ్మండ్ ఫ్రాయిడ్ ఏం చేశాడు, ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్స్ ద్వారా the problem of man is in the subconscious mind annadu. Akkada aagipoyindi, akkada bayitiki raatal ledu, chadda vishayalu maatram bayitiki vastunnayi. He is lured by the lust and gold and he lives by lust and gold annadu. Aithe mana rushulu em annaru, amrutasya putraha. So kontha varaku patience, rendodi mana sadhana, ee rendu chestu unte, third is daiva anugraham. After once you have done and offered to God, offer to the divine mother, meer inga bayapada avasaram ledhu. You are a child. There are two things, two children are there. One is holding the father's hand, another is father is holding the child's hand. Who is safe? The father who is holding the child takes care of the child, but the child has to give his hand to God. God is stretching his hand, but you are taking away the hand. Oddu oddu are, give it to God. That is sharanagati. Nannu cheppa kada sharanagati. So that is very important sadhana. Prayatnam cheyandi. May divine mother Durga bless you, may holy mother Sharada Devi bless you, and we hope and wish your journey will be smooth and you will attain moksha as early as possible. Thank you, Amma. Practice cheyandi. So we'll meet tomorrow. Namaste, Shubhadinam, Shubharatri. May Bhagavan Shri Krishna bless you. May Mother Durga bless you. Hari Om, Tat Sat. Tomorrow morning, 8:15, 8:20.